This right here,
this isn't just another mini split install. This is history in the making. What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Thank you so much for tuning in. It's me, Mikey Pipes with DC HVAC. And today, we're breaking ground on something new. Yeah, that's a Fujitsu. That's their R32 A2L refrigerant ductless indoor unit. This is a 24,000 BTU model. We're gonna install that in that room. Let's go! So Daniel and I, we're gonna walk you through the entire install, step by step, and share a few things you must know about working with an A2L refrigerant. So grab your gauges, grab your torches, let's get this Fujitsu system installed. Let's go! All right, so one of the first things we're gonna be doing is installing the wall-mounted bracket. You could also start inside, working on the indoor unit first, but we're starting on the outdoor unit. I got one lag bolt through my stucco, going through the foam, and then going into plywood. We got two different sizes here because I am using stucco. I had the 4.5 and also the 5.5-inch long lag bolts. We'll check inside, make sure we're not penetrating too far, make sure we're not penetrating any thing that we shouldn't be, but this is that open area and the staircase is on the other side, so we should still be within the wall cavity with no problems. We'll throw a level on here, make sure we're level, and then get the other lag bolt secure.
It's like a hair over 22.5.
Okay, so the center of our feet is 22.5, so we're going to set our brackets 22.5 inches. Once we're level, which we're dead level, we're gonna secure a couple bolts on this side and one on that side. I wanna concentrate more bolts on the right-hand side because that's where the majority of the weight is, because that's where the inverter is. Excellent. Oh, you give me the heavy side.
It's not heavy.
I know. What is the heavier side? Wow, look, I did this before. It's awesome. Just like I did it before. Love it. That looks so nice, by the way.
Nuts built into that, or we put our own nut on?
That's a great question.
Yeah, we put our own nut on.
So. This is why I like using the wall mount bracket by Rector Seal, which Asher knows at Ferguson. The only thing is Ferguson sucks. You have the nuts
underneath?
And washers.
There's
no Blackman suck too, but Ferguson never has anything in stock. And they have their own special brands.
Yeah.
Oh, look, I never noticed this before. It has an AHRI certified sticker.
Oh, that hasn't been there before.
You haven't seen that before?
That's not been
I have never seen that before. Check this out. I've never seen that sticker before. An AHRI certified. Unitary small heat pump system. Look at that. Huh. Wow. Then I guess they need to justify a higher price for this equipment, this A2L R32 equipment. You know that AHRI is getting paid. You know they're getting paid.
Certification companies
get paid, I know. I know. Alright, tighten up our feet. Be good to go. I love it how it says federal law prohibits removal of this label. I just committed a federal felony. Alright, we're gonna have to get a little creative. Because our disconnect panel is, I don't know, they stuccoed around the disconnect panel. We normally put our surge protector there. So, we don't really have room on our outdoor unit where the line voltage comes in. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna drill a hole, probably like right here, right? And we have a little spot right there. And we're gonna drill a hole here. Our surge protector will come out here. I was thinking about putting it on top, but that's gonna look stupid. But or in the front. It's also gonna look stupid. Put it in the back. We'll drill a hole there. Daniel's got a step bit on the drill already. He's gonna make a hole and he's gonna realize that we are
just tight.
Maybe I could maybe we should let's see. Remember, don't skip.
I know. I wanna make sure I'm hitting ones.
Surge protector in there.
Yeah, no.
You know, maybe have it pointing like on the side or whatever. Yeah, that way. And that way when you're servicing it, you can see the lights, status lights. It's very nice. We're using the ICM 518. Huge shout out to ICM. They are a company based in upstate New York. They used to be a previous sponsor of the channel. They sent us a bunch of cool stuff like the 518 surge protector device. You can get this on Amazon, or I'll put a link in the description box down below. If you do buy from Amazon or in description or one of the links I send you, I could make a small commission on that. Small meaning like a few pennies, a few shekel, nothing crazy. So dealing right now is tightening up the locking nuts, and then we will wire up line voltage. All right, we are in this room that looks like the spray foam machine vomited in. It really did. There was spray foam injected into the cavities of these walls and ceilings. There's been leaks. Those leaks have been fixed. We have this curved wall here, which starts here and goes all the way around there. This is going to be the homeowner's, I guess, office, right? And if I showed you what was behind me, you guys would be like, damn, I need to have an office like that. But we'll get to that later. So the general contractor built a wall here. And we have a piece of plywood there. And we're going to put centered the indoor unit. We're going to go down. We're going to utilize that chase where this 2-inch PVC is. We're going to rip that out. And we're going to put our line set, communication wire, and drain all in that line there.
You want to go outside and pull it?
Maybe.
Yeah. Oh, watch out for hanging wires.
I'm wondering how the hell they ran this stuff originally.
I don't know.
Because there was a split unit in here.
There was?
Yeah.
Oh.
Otherwise, no way you get heat or air conditioning in here.
Well, heat is a radiant, but...
No, you really can't. I mean, they could have originally... Originally, they could have. They did.
Okay. Should be good, right? Okay. Perfect.
All right, so we cut out the 2-inch PVC that ran from there. It was part of the old roof drain. Now the roof drain goes outside that way. Why they didn't do that to begin with, I don't know, but We cut out all the PVC and use that as our chase for our half inch and our quarter inch and the communication line from the outdoor unit in to the indoor unit. Okay, we took a measurement and we found our center, which is there. We got approval from the homeowner. We're not centering with the lights, we're centering with the room. And we got lucky with a stud here, but we did not get lucky in the right-hand side with studs. So what we did, we took some wood. 2x4s right there. We got a couple on the bottom right and the top left-hand side. So that top is secure. This top is secure. That's not going anywhere. So with 2, 4, 6, 8 screws, a little overkill, but I'm sure you've seen much more if you ever replace a ductless mini split system. You know, I've seen 20 screws holding this in like it was a screw sale, but not necessary. We're going to take a measurement where we're going to come out with our line set. We are going to come out on the left-hand side, unlike the traditional right-hand side, because we're not going straight out the back to the exterior. We're going inside the wall. So our line sets are going to come up here, and we'll stub out, and we'll let the sheetrock guy, the plasterer guy, and the painter have fun before we come back and do the final head install. That's a nice hole. All right, now we run some line set. We're paying very close attention not to kink the line. Yeah, we can go a little bit more. There you go, perfect. Okay. And we'll turn it a little bit so it's against the wall, because you know how those sheetrock guys are. Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, liquid line. Gas, liquid. Liquid and vapor. All right, I ran some extra long wire for our communication to the indoor unit from the outdoor unit. I sleeved the corrugated drain tubing in 3/4 inch PVC. I threw a 3/4 inch PVC conduit long turn 90 there, and it went right outside utilizing an existing hole that was there. I got a little 1 inch copper strap there holding that into place. And I know how contractors are. I know how nails work, and because of the history of water damage in this room, I am not going to be the cause, or my equipment is not going to be the cause of future leaks in this home, that's for sure. Let's go focus our attention outside and get these lines connected. All right, we are now at the outdoor unit. Daniel already has L1, L2, and our ground wire connected utilizing those Wago lever connectors, the 221s. For 3-conductor wiring, because we have our ICM518 surge protector for split phase. We even have the zip ties there securing the line voltage wiring to those wire holders. We're working on the communication wire. We have black, white, red, and green. That's going to go on 1, 2, and 3, black, white, red. Green is to our ground, of course. Now, since these are a stranded wire, not a solid wire, we're going to use some connectors on there to get those wiring secure on the terminals. So Daniel's got his cool little wire crimper tool, and we're going to crimp down on that connector terminal to the wiring. Look at that. If you're not using those kind of connectors on stranded wire, I suggest you read the manual and follow the instructions on how to properly install equipment. You okay over there?
It's tight.
Yeah, I've heard that expression before. See how that is.
It's okay.
It's solid. And don't worry, guys, next we're going to use the torque wrench to tighten up the half inch and quarter inch refrigeration lines that already loosely fitted. We used a piece of Liquitite to cover up our communication wire as well. Very, very nice. Nice little touch. And last but not least, excellent. There you go. And we'll make those connections to the terminal block. All right, I got the yellow jacket torque wrench here. We are going to set it for a little over 13 pounds for that quarter inch flare connection. Daniel is dialing it in, and then we are going to torque it. Nope, I know, I almost lost all the screws. I hate it when you step on it. All the screws fall out. Oh, there it is, see? Lefty loosey, righty tighty. Perfect. So now we're gonna change the heads for the half inch and dial that in. And in case you're wondering what we are dialing this into, if you RTFM, read the factory manual, you'll know the torquing size for the flare nut you're working with. And here you go on page English 9, half inch, which is 12.7 millimeters, or 36.1 to 45 pounds per foot. Or if you are not on the imperial system and you're on the neutric metric tons, whatever that's called, right? My neutric metric tons?
Newton meters.
You're going to be at 49 to 61. But RTFM, ladies and gentlemen, read the factory manual.
Nobody in the world uses it outside a laboratory. It makes them seem like they're smarter.
Oh, there you go. You got a little worried there. Like, oh, I don't think it's working.
It seemed like a lot.
Yeah. I know.
Foot-pounds are better measure because everybody actually knows what the hell it means.
Yeah. So some of you may be wondering, Mikey Pipes, why are you doing the indoor unit now? Where's the vacuum pump? Well, there is a part two, ladies and gentlemen. You see, if I were to install the indoor evaporator high wall unit on the wall now, the chances that it be completely filled with sheetrock dust and spackle dust and all that other nasty stuff is a guarantee. It's a sure thing. So we ran the electric, we ran the drain, we ran the line sets, we mounted the wall mount bracket up on the wall, and in the next week and a half, this room is going to be drastically transformed by a crew to make this look epic. And our unit is going to be showcased dead center. So stick around for part two, ladies and gentlemen, where we show you the proper tools and techniques to handle an A2L refrigerant system like this Fujitsu 24,000 BTU system using refrigerant R32. Catch you in the next one. Be well. God bless. Stay safe. Make sure you smash that thumbs up button. And don't subscribe because I'm already at the goal. We're at 180,000 subscribers, and I like that number. It's a good number. It's a good number. So don't subscribe. Love you guys.